I did not put that weight on correctly. I'm putting that back to 330. So I did 320 last time, so now it's on 330. I might only get like 4 or 5 reps right here, but it'll be all right. Oof. All right, 3, 2, 1. Oh, that was 5 reps on my own right there, which felt good, but those weren't, but it wasn't the best quality reps. So I'm gonna lower the weight to 310 next set and focus on a bit more quality reps, hopefully 6 to 8 rather than just 5. Whew, that was so good though for maxing the machine out almost entirely. There's only 3 more 5-pound add-ons before I max out everything. So we're almost there. Yeah, that felt good. Let's go ahead and knock out the second working set. Whew, and this is the last working set that we'll be doing of this very specific machine. Same thing as the warm-up when it comes to the form. And just now, we're gonna be taking this set all the way until failure. I think I got like 6 last time on my own, so anywhere from 6 to 9 will be good. Get the straps on real tight. 1.5 times shoulder width. And we're gonna have a great set. This is with 20 pounds assisted, and we did 70 pounds assisted for the first warm-up set. Let's do this. Whew. Partials at the end of that feel incredible. Lat pull down partials feel good too, but in my opinion, they're nothing in comparison to the partials you feel on this. That is crazy. Whew. And that was the first working set of this movement. And now we're gonna chill and rest for at least 3 minutes before we do our next working. Now if you happen, let's do the second working set. 1. Damn it. Oh, my right hand fell off. Yeah. Pause. Pause. Holy shit. I fucked up with my right hand right there. It was a little bit too wide, and I was trying to adjust it halfway through. I think it made me lose like one rep, but that was still a good set regardless. Whew. And next, we'll be heading over.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I think so. Because it's the mic. Yeah.
I was going to say. What was I going to say? Oh, all the stuff he's telling y'all, none of it matters as much as the fact that he just works that hard, bro.
That is a fair point. If you
are
following.
Look how much he's sweating compared to me.
That is a good point. If you're not willing to actually apply the effort required, you're simply not going to grow. You can do the exact same workout, diet plan, everything. Is your favorite workout, you know, influencer, YouTuber? If you don't put in the same effort, you're not gonna get the same results.
Biggest thing y'all can
learn. What's up? But yeah, let's head into the other room and do some wide grip rows. I also see my editor, Caleb, over here doing the lean forward, pec deck machine press fly variation. Oh, this is pull-ups.
So you got the
wide grip rows? You already know. You got everything fucking memorized.
You got the whole
yeah.
Making it a free training session.
Hell yeah. I don't mind. It's helping me train hard as shit too. So we're having a good workout. Yeah, we're going to head over and do some wide grip rows. And after that, finish off with a single arm low rows. So yeah, I'll see you, bro. I just want to say what's up. And with this machine, I'll try and always ensure that I'm not letting my ego get the best of me. Because I feel like this machine in particular is, for one, the most fatiguing back exercise that I do. But it's also the easiest to accidentally ego lift. If that even like makes sense. Pretty much it's easier to use more momentum than you are trying to use, which then makes it to where you're not really, you're hitting the muscles as effectively as possible. So pretty much what I'm trying to say is with this set, I'm gonna try my hardest to ensure that I am not using a ton of momentum to lift the weight. So I want my form to be relatively strict. And let's do it. God. Ooh, does this look sick?
Yeah.
Oh. Hopefully that looked solid on stream. But what's
you're
up?
You're tripping about your body?
Oh, just like bulking and shit?
Yeah, but when you're doing that, your back is like...
Looks crazy?
Insane. Like you have like single veins on your...
Shit, that's falling. Thank you, bro. Wild. I appreciate that, man. I'm trying to just keep on going and get bigger and bigger.
Oh. What you do, you want to keep your elbows up on this thing?
Yeah, keep them flared. It might feel a little bit awkward or uncomfortable, but definitely make sure your elbows are flared as much as possible. We're now going to do the second working set of this movement. It looks pretty good already.
Yeah, give me a little flex.
Yeah. Oh, sweet. Oh. Can we go ahead and refresh this? Are we in the just chatting category or the... fitness and health? Yes, we are. Perfect. All right. Let's go ahead and put this on 137 and a half for this next set. And let's do this. We've got two more sets left, so are you finished up right there?
Yeah, I just finished.
You can just leave it then. You're good, no worries. So instead of doing two sets of the single arm low rows. We're gonna do two sets right here instead. And with this machine, pretty much the only difference is it's not going to be single arm. I'm gonna be using both hands on these outer handles to ensure my elbows come back to a 45 degree angle. And we're gonna do two sets of this. And after this, we will be done with back. Whew. Honestly, this workout, back and triceps, doesn't really ever take too long at all. It's a fun workout, but I'm glad it doesn't take forever. There we go. Now it's working on my end. But yeah, let's do this. Oh my God. Oh. Yeah, that was insane. But like I said, not doing single arm. So we can now rest for 2.5, 3 minutes before we do the next working set of this. But yeah, let's do the second working set. Whew. Oh shit. I will say it's definitely the hardest part of this movement is after failing, if like rest for an extra like 4 or 5 seconds just to gather the energy to pick it up and put it back in its starting position. Because that was not easy. Whew. But like I said, that was the 8th and final working set of back. So now we're gonna do 2 rounds of the mechanical drop set with one of the cables that's around here. It'll be with a long ergonomic rope so we can go behind our back. Yo, I honestly might do the drop set right here just so we can have a bit of a change in scenery when it comes to where we normally do this at. I was just talking about you, man.
Why?
Cause I was gonna ask how many sets you have left on the cable machine. I was gonna put it all the way to the top is why I was asking. Nah, fuck you, man. Get off my machine, bro. I'm streaming, get off. I have privilege, get off, man. Get off my stream, man. I got privilege. I got streaming privilege, man. All right, buddy, get off. When I come back and see there's one viewer, I'm gonna get mad at you, man. All right.
I got about 3 more, actually.
3 more? Make that like half a set more, and then we'll be good. But yeah, while he's knocking out his 1 or 2 more sets, I'm gonna do 1 quick warm-up on here, and afterwards, we'll flip the camera around and head right there. Damn, this lighting is some hot ass. You hitting this tricep mechanical drop set with me, man? Are you doing the tricep mechanical drop set with me, man? You are? Hell yeah. Let's do it then, man. Let's load it up. Hey, man, quit doing that. I'll fuck you up.
Oh. Supposed to be doing chest today, but...
What happened, man? Why'd you skip chest?
I already did. I'm done. I'm bored, so...
What are you doing then? Push? Total?
I've started a bro split. I copied you.
What do you mean copy me? I'm not doing bro split.
I thought y'all were doing bro split. I thought you and Colton were doing bro split.
I'm doing like... Not really bro split at all. It's more so I'm just having longer frequency in between each workout, which I guess off the top of your head, it sounds like a bro split, but I'm not doing one muscle group per workout. I'm usually doing two or three. Huh?
I turned into a broccoli head.
Oh, I know, man. I know. He just called you basic with a bro split? Hey, man. I'm not the one with a bro split. That's him. He's the one that's basic, man. Yeah, man. I'm talking shit, man. All right. Let me go ahead and knock this in, man.
How many?
Three movements. Holy crap. Oh my gosh. All right, come on. Holy crap. Oh. Oh my gosh. You got it, bruh. Damn. That feels absolutely insane on the triceps. All right, let's knock out this first working set of this machine dip press. Well, hello there. What's up? I love having wide shoulders. Three. Actually, I need to up the weight to 210. We're still on 155 of the warm-up. It's 210 now. Let's do this. Three, two, one. Whew. Oh, holy frick, that was insane. Whew. Honestly, I think I got 6 or 7 right there, so I'm gonna leave the weight on 210. So I think I've been doing 210 and then 200, so I'm gonna leave the weight on 210 for both sets. So we are still progressively overloading with triceps. Because like I said multiple times, even though they're not the main focus whatsoever of my split, they're still growing like crazy. I just switched my split, right? Yeah, switched back pretty much to my old split that I was doing on prep, where I do chest, biceps, and shoulders, then back and triceps, then rest, then legs, then shoulders and triceps, or shoulders and arms, then rest again. I need to find a better balance, not even better balance, more so find a more consistent way to be able to have two meals before every single workout, because last year I only worked out after just one meal. What I'm thinking with the new split, I actually haven't even done a shoulder and arm like workout whatsoever. I've been sticking to the chest, biceps and shoulders, back and tries, then legs, like just doing those three. So I'm gonna have to throw in the shoulder and arm day. And I'm just gonna have to figure out how I'm gonna adjust my split with that, because I have it with a full like 10-day split basis that I sent to TNF. I actually need to memorize that and like write it down on paper and figure out more of a plan for it. Because right now, I'm hitting every single workout in order, but I'm a bit lost entirely on like where I'm even at with my split, like week to week. I don't even know if I'm making full complete sense, but pretty much my split got changed while I was in the middle of a, you know, the other rotation with my other split. So it confused me and threw me off, but we're still hitting every single workout in roughly the same order. I pretty much just have to now implement a shoulder and arm day after my hamstring focused leg day, and that's it. So only one shoulder and arm day every 10 days, which I've never done before, but that's what I'm going to be doing from here on out on the bulk. So that's why it's been confusing, is because I've never done that style of like a split where I do only one workout every 10 days. So I'll figure out which leg day I'm gonna do it after. I just said hamstring focus, so I guess next one will be quad focused. So I won't do a shoulder and arm day after the next leg day, but I will with the one after that. So next shoulder and arm workout will probably be in like 7 to 9 days. Struggling with the math right now, but somewhere around there. W yapping, LOLJK. Hey man, I know I am a yapper, but hopefully I got my point across right there. I was struggling to even like figure out what I was trying to say, but yeah, having the extra shoulder and arm day only once every 10 days, that's what has thrown me off. That's the only like main difference from what I was doing in prep. But yeah, let's do this, man. Last working set, and after that, we'll head to the bathroom and see how we are looking and how we are feeling. So if you guys have any questions whatsoever right now about literally anything, go ahead and ask right now, because after this, I will be closing out the stream relatively soon. Actually, we have two sets of rear delts too. So after this, we're gonna knock out two quick sets of rear delts and then we'll be done. I almost forgot rear delts again since I did literally 10 days ago. That's what kind of forced me to remember. Oof. All right, 3, 2, 1. Ugh. Oh. Jesus. That was insane. Holy crap. So yeah, like I said, we're not done with the workout because I was really about to accidentally skip rear delts. I didn't skip rear delts last back then, but I did with the one before that. So it's 6 days a week too much. If you're working out 6 days in a row, your intensity is most likely not really where it should be. I'm a big fan or big believer of, if you're doing more than 3 days in a row of working out without needing a rest day, you're most likely not training anywhere near as hard as you should be, unless your volume is set up to where you don't need any rest days. Like for example, my coach TNF, I believe he doesn't take any rest days, or he takes very minimal rest days compared to me, but his volume is also a lot different than mine, which allows him to then have much less rest days than what I do. My volume is higher workout to workout, which is why I need more rest days. So hopefully that makes sense. You can do more rest days or less rest days, but it comes down to the volume you're doing workout to workout. That's why I take many rest days, because if I were to try to do the same amount of volume every single workout 6 days in a row, like after the third workout, I'd be having shitty lifts every single time. Like, I'd probably have solid workouts for the first three, but then the three directly after that, every single lift would not be good at all. And that's actually a huge reason as to why I plateaued so much within my first couple years, because I was doing way too much training and not enough resting. Oh my gosh. Okay. Kason had my wisdom teeth out yesterday morning, and the doctor said I was talking about you when I woke up. That's awesome, man. I love that, man. Jeez, bro, this lighting is so crazy. Appreciate you all. This is an awesome workout. Great stream. Felt good the entire way. I'm shaking the camera right now because I'm so freaking stimmed out. But yeah, appreciate you all. It was a great workout. Back and triceps is now complete. Go ahead and follow if you have not already, because this is just the beginning, I promise you guys. Love you all. See you all in the next one.